My top four mistakes that I actually made buying silver. Oh man, to be honest with you, everybody makes mistakes. And I'm gonna tell you my biggest mistake I actually done in my stacking career, all right? So hopefully you guys won't fall in this category, or hopefully you guys can actually avoid these mistakes, okay? So let's get to it. So welcome to another video of Urban Lifestyle, where our goal is to help you create a better life by creating better health and wealth. And you guys can also help out by leaving a subscribe, leaving a thumbs up, and also hitting that notification icon so you guys can get future notifications of my future videos. Let's get into the intro. This thing is still dirty from the last video I actually recorded. That doesn't help out at all. All right, much better. So let's get into it. Mistake number one. If you guys are an avid viewer of this channel, then you should know this one already. Buying 1 gram of silver. I actually used to buy grams of silver, which made no sense. Now that I'm looking back at it, of course. I think I used to buy them for how much? I think about almost $2. Now, if you think about it, I was actually paying over like $30 for 1 ounce. Of silver, when an ounce of silver is actually what, $16. So I was paying double the price of an actual ounce of silver when I could have just brought the ounce of silver, which made no sense. Now let me tell you the reason I fell in this trap. Now if you do the equation, if you take 1 gram at $2, right, and it's easier to buy, of course, I looked at it like the stock market. If I was able to buy a whole bunch of them at $2, right, and silver just happens to go up by $40. That means the grams would be worth a good $4, right? So I saw it as, hey, if I buy a whole bunch of grams and it just goes up by $4, that means if I brought $2,000 worth, I'm gonna actually make a whole $2,000 profit. That's how I saw it, and that was the move, because if I brought 1 ounce silver at $2,000, then I'll actually make more than I would buying grams. So that's why that was stupid. Mistake number two, buying at the pawn shop. Now, I only brought silver once at the pawn shop. I pretty much knew it was overpriced, but it was something in my collection, so I know I'm not going to make money off it, but it's not something I'm going to go do all the time and buy at the pawn shop, because they're there to make money. All businesses are there to make money. Okay, so that's why when you buy silver, there's a premium added on to it. So yeah, that's the second mistake. Don't do it. I wouldn't do it again. Matter of fact, I wouldn't even sell it at the pawn shop either, because they're gonna lowball you. My third biggest mistake is actually going in with no information. Okay, I didn't know nothing about the gold. I didn't know nothing about silver. I just know I wanted to start buying. Matter of fact, I did not know that stacking was actually the word used for it. I just said, hey, I just want to buy gold and I want to buy silver just to have. I didn't know there was a community doing it. So I just went and I started collecting a whole bunch of gold and silver. I didn't know how to. I just went in with no info. Then I found an online service called Atmex, and then that's when I started knowing that there's a community, and I just didn't ask nobody. I just went head on. Because remember, only 6% of the population is actually stacking gold and silver. And out of those 6%, I didn't know none of them. Okay? Now I do, obviously, thanks to YouTube, but I didn't know no information prior to, so pretty much I was stuck on gimmick. I'll buy this gold $100 bill because it looks good and I just want to have it, because hey, I end up paying about like anywhere between $70-$80 on a gold that has $100 on it. I mean, I still love it. As a matter of fact, that's one of my first videos that I actually posted on here, and it still gets views to this day. But honestly, for a gram of gold, I could have got it at about $40-$50, but I paid over extra $30 for it. So I count it as a mistake. But hey, it's still a good mistake to have, because I still have it. And honestly, I was thinking about just buying a whole bunch of them at one point. Like having like over 100 of them. Good thing I learned about it, right? The fourth and final mistake is actually buying at full price. Now when you go online and you buy gold and silver, they give you a couple of options. You can pay with your credit card, PayPal, or debit, or you can send in a check or do a wire transfer. Now I didn't want to send a check, I didn't want to do wire transfer, so obviously the best way I knew how and it would have been faster was to actually use my credit card. Not knowing that, hey, I save a couple of more bucks, like 5 to 20 bucks. Like, I have a video on here, $2,000 golden box, and that whole $2,000 was actually made by a credit card, which means they could have took off a good $40, $50, maybe even $60 that I could have brought more stuff with, but I actually paid for it. So you guys may want to utilize the feature of e-check, even though it's gonna be a bit longer for you guys to actually receive it, or write them a check and mail it, and it's gonna take even longer for you guys to actually receive your precious metals. But hey, patience is key, and Silver Butcher taught me that. But that's pretty much my top four mistakes. There's been plenty, but from what I can count off right now, these are the four biggest ones. Buying 1 gram, buying it at a pawn shop, not getting any knowledge or information, and buying at full price. If you guys made any of these mistakes, let me know right down in the comments. Let's have a conversation. But hopefully you guys found this video of value. If you did, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button, leave a thumbs up, comment down below, and don't forget to hit that notification button so you guys can get future notifications of my future videos. Thank you guys for watching, and have a good one. That's why I work.